When life gives scientists lemons, they look at those lemons and say, how can we use this to test general relativity? Hi everyone, Julian here for DNews. I know we've been doing it for a while now, but launching stuff into space is still pretty tricky. You gotta get a giant rocket on a launch pad without it exploding, and then you've gotta start it up without it exploding, and then you've gotta get it into space without it exploding. But assuming the payload still stays intact, sometimes the rocket just puts it in the wrong place. And that's what happened in August of 2014 with a Russian Soyuz Forget rocket carrying two of the European Space Agency's Galileo satellites. The rocket worked flawlessly most of the way up there, and then in the last stage, it pointed in the wrong direction and shot them off in an orbit that made them useless for their intended purpose. So close. Of course, we're talking close by space standards, which is just another way of saying the orbits were really far off. They were supposed to be in circular orbits, a constant 23,222 kilometers away from the Earth, and instead they were set on elliptical orbits. Twice a day, they were 2,000 kilometers too high, and twice a day, they were 10,000 kilometers too low. The Galileo program is going to be fine. The plan is to launch 30 satellites to use them for global positioning, and really 24 of them are needed for the system to be fully operational, while the remaining 6 are there for backup. So two of them whizzing about in the wrong place is a minor setback rather than a deal breaker. But heck, while they're up there, we may as well do something with them, right? I mean, they've still got fully functioning atomic clocks on board, so what experiments could you do with a spacecraft traveling in an elliptical orbit around a massive object while carrying super accurate clocks? If you said test time dilation, you must watch this show a lot. Hi, Mom. Yes, as you're probably aware, according to Albert Einstein's theory of general relativity, near massive objects, time moves slower. GPS satellites already have to constantly adjust their atomic clocks back slightly because of their distance from the Earth. And yes, according to special relativity, their speed also means that their clocks should run a little slower, but the overall effect is the super accurate clocks in space are a little fast on the order of microseconds. The Wayward Galileo satellites have had some course corrections because they had thrusters with a bit of hydrazine fuel. Now their orbits change by 8,500 kilometers twice a day instead of 12,000. But that's still a greater difference than the radius of the Earth and then some. So what that means is, compared to our atomic clocks down here, the misplaced Galileo clocks will run a little faster, then a lot faster, then a little faster, then a lot faster as they get closer and farther away from this massive hunk. I mean the Earth, not me. Using those differences, we'll be able to check Einstein's math. And sure, we did it once before with an atomic clock in 1976 that hitched a ride 10,000 kilometers into space, but that experiment only lasted a few hours. We can pull data from these satellites over a year and be 4 times more accurate than before, and we'll be able to test the math versus the measurements to an accuracy of 0.004%. And we'll be able to do it all thanks to a mistake that we turned into a happy little accident. And I've got more good news, everybody. Test Tube now has a newsletter. Get a weekly roundup of our most popular videos across all our shows at testtube.com/forward. So I glossed over how GPS satellites work, and though I'd love to ramble all about them, Trace's clock was a little faster than mine, and he beat me to it. Check out the amazing science behind knowing where on Earth you are right here.
Smartphones and GPS units have to have very precise time because microwave signals travel at the speed of light, roughly 300,000 kilometers per second. So in a fraction of a second, the signal travels from each satellite to you.
Have you ever turned an almost fail into an epic win? Sure you have. So let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on DNews.